Chapter 1 of The Coral Island by R. M. Ballantyne. Roving has always been, and still is, my ruling passion, the joy of my heart, the very sunshine of my existence. It was a wild, black night of howling storm, the night on which I was born on the foaming bosom of the broad Atlantic Ocean. My father was a sea captain, my grandfather was a sea captain, my great-grandfather had been a marine. Nobody could tell positively what occupation his father had followed, but my dear mother used to assert that he had been a midshipman, whose grandfather, on the mother's side, had been an admiral in the Royal Navy. At any rate, we knew that as far back as our family could be traced, it had been intimately connected with the great watery waste. Indeed, this was the case on both sides of the house, for my mother always went to sea with my father on his long voyages, and so spent the greater part of her life upon the water. Thus it was, I suppose, that I came to inherit a roving disposition. Soon after I was born, my father, being old, retired from a seafaring life, purchased a small cottage in a fishing village on the west coast of England, and settled down to spend the evening of his life on the shores of that sea which had for so many years been his home. My father bound me apprentice to a coasting vessel and let me go to sea. For some years I was happy in visiting the seaports, and in coasting along the shores, of my native land. My Christian name was Ralph, and my comrades added to this the name of Rover, in consequence of the passion which I always evinced for traveling. Now, while engaged in the coasting trade, I fell in with many seamen who had traveled to almost every quarter of the globe, and I freely confess that my heart glowed ardently within me as they recounted their wild adventures in foreign lands, the dreadful storms they had weathered, the appalling dangers they had escaped, the wonderful creatures they had seen both on the land and in the sea, and the interesting lands and strange people they had visited. But of all the places of which they told me, none captivated and charmed my imagination so much as the coral islands of the southern seas. They told me of thousands of beautiful, fertile islands that had been formed by a small creature called the coral insect, where summer reigned nearly all the year round, where the trees were laden with a constant harvest of luxuriant fruit, where the climate was almost perpetually delightful. Yet where, strange to say, men were wild, bloodthirsty savages, excepting in those favored isles to which the gospel of our Savior had been conveyed. These exciting accounts had so great an effect upon my mind that, when I reached the age of 15, I resolved to make a voyage to the South Seas. I had no little difficulty, at first, in prevailing on my dear parents to let me go, but when I urged on my father that he would never have become a great captain had he remained in the coasting trade, he saw the truth of what I said and gave his consent. My father placed me under the charge of an old messmate of his own, a merchant captain, who was on the point of sailing to the South Seas in his own ship, the Arrow. My mother gave me her blessing and a small Bible, and her last request was that I would never forget to read a chapter every day and say my prayers, which I promised, with tears in my eyes, that I would certainly do. Soon afterwards I went on board the Arrow, which was a fine, large ship, and set sail for the islands of the Pacific Ocean.